starting off with the jobs report. Came in at 830, came in up 80,000. That was a disappointment. That was below what the market expected. That was not a good number in any sort of absolute term, except for the fact that it's not negative. Let's get right to Kathleen Madigan, who is here with us to sort of talk about the numbers and the implications, what this means. What does this mean for the economy, Kathleen Madigan?
This is what 2% growth looks like. You know, and the implication is consumers, who are mostly workers, just don't have the paychecks coming in, you know, either rising or getting new ones,
right,
to support a big boost in spending coming into the second half. It's just going to be dreary. I'm not saying recession. I'm just saying 1.5-2% growth.
Yeah, we had our colleague, I just saw this, Spencer Jacob, who tweeted that this now puts a sort of rolling three-month average at about 75,000,
right,
which is basically a third of where we were in the first quarter. So, and you can see from that chart there,
right, yeah,
you can see the fall off there. Let's talk quickly about what this means for the Federal Reserve, because a lot of people, beginning about a month ago, the beginning of June, started talking about the Fed intervening, the Fed doing QE3, Fed doing something. To me, this report is the exact opposite of what they would want.
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
Right.
I mean, you know, because they, you know, even though you still have some hawks on the Fed who worry about price pressures, it's the name of the game for the Fed is boosting job growth. And it's just not there. Now, it's interesting, though, even with this disappointing job growth, most economists think that the Fed is not going to do anything at the end of July when they meet. And to be honest, I'm not sure that a third round of quantitative easing is really going to make much of a difference. You know, the problem here isn't credit availability.
Right.
It's the demand for credit and the fact that even people who are in good financial shape don't want to borrow. You know, the exception being cars. I still find the high level of car sales
surprising.
Because it runs counter to
right.
all these other bad numbers. But I'm not sure that, say, buying more mortgage-backed securities is going to change the thinking
the
among
dynamic,
businesses.
Right. And how does the Fed justify doing another giant big QE3, big bond buying program, when you do have job growth? It's not great, but you do have it. You do have the S&P at 1350, 1355. You know, the stock market isn't plunging. We don't have negative jobs numbers. We just have piddling growth.
Right.
So it's hard for the Fed, given everything they've done, given the fact, like you said, liquidity is not an issue. Access to credit is not the issue. Mm-hmm. It's hard for them to come in and say, we're going to do another program.
Yeah, and to be honest, I think that Bernanke wants to hold back unless Europe falls apart.
Right.
Or they're looking into 2013 and looking at this fiscal cliff, which means all these spending cuts and tax hikes that are on target. I mean, these are what the current law is calling for. And if Washington doesn't do something, the Fed is going to have to act.
Right, right. That sort of de facto tightening alone could push us into a
recession. Definitely.
Let's talk for a second about where the jobs were created last month. That's what we're looking at here. And you can see where the jobs were created.
Mm-hmm.
None of those numbers are that great, are they?
Well, manufacturing, yes, 11,000 doesn't look like that's great, but it is, I believe, a pickup from the previous 3 months. And given the secular downtrend in manufacturing, simply because they're more productive, they rely more on capital than labor, that is a positive. Construction, yes, they gained jobs, but they cut 35,000
right,
in May.
Right,
so,
and you see the unemployment rate basically flat.
Yeah.
Now, I want
now
to talk
that
about
is actually what the Fed is looking at.
At the unemployment rate, and that it is. I mean, it's just 8.2, bang.
Bang.
Yeah. I want to talk about one positive thing that came out of this report.
Okay.
Average hourly earnings, which I thought were very interesting. You look at them on a
year-over-year
basis, up 2%. They were up 6 cents, you know, this month.
Yeah.
But yearly, they were up 2%. And I went and looked at the consumer price, the latest consumer price report.
Uh-huh.
The unadjusted, all-inclusive number was
1.7%. So we're finally making.
So, you know, look, it's a rose in rocky soil. But, I mean, it's, you know, a little bit above inflation. There's a little bit of a positive there for you.
Yeah. No, and, like, you know, we'll take our good news where we can get it. You know, hours worked was a little longer, so that helps paychecks as well.
Right.
And with job growth, that does mean the personal income is going to be a positive, but really it's just not strong
enough. Yeah, we're so far away from what is a good economy, a strong growing economy.
But as one economist said, you know, this is the new normal. Yeah.